Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and in this video we'll see how to get the images from the storage. So in the last video we have uploaded the image to the storage. Now we will get those data back and see how to show it in the app. So this is the 8th video in our app type series, and let's get started. So if you see, if I make it bigger and go to storage, we have a to do, and see, I have image picker and I have done an image, I have uploaded the image, right? So we get the file ID here. Now let's take it one step further. So here I say add image, right? So let me go to the add to do screen. Then I have the title, I have the image, I have the description, I have the image path, right? So let's see what we are doing. So add to do, I have icon, add image, okay, container, okay. So here I am setting the path. Now after that, what I am doing is I am sending this data to the create to do. So let's go to the create to do and see what we are doing. So first we are uploading the image. So after I upload the image, what I should get, right? So here if you see, I have a create file. So this is a file type, so I will make it final file. Okay, so file, what is file? It says it gives me ID, it gives me bucket ID, it gives me created add. Okay, fine. So we need to get the file here. So where is it? Create, right? So here I will write file equals to await upload image ID, and in this here I will make it async. And then try, let's get the file and this return. I will return file. Okay, so we don't get error, we know that, right? So now here we write title, description is done, created at user ID. We will also add two new fields, which will become image ID. So it will be file.id. Okay, and then it will become bucket ID. So we will make it file dot bucket ID. Fine. So let me just check once. So if I go to file, you see this is the file ID. Then we have the bucket ID. Now image ID and bucket ID. So what we need to do first? We need to add this here. So we need to go to database, we need to go to this part, we need to go to to do. Here we go to attribute. Now here we need to create attribute. So for this, our attribute would be image ID, and then it will take a string, not an array. So size maybe something 1024, let's give it a thing. Okay, I don't have the image, so image ID, and then we will need a bucket ID. So here I give bucket ID, I give string create. Fine. So now let's create a, now let's upload an image and let's see, right? So let's do one thing, let's say test 3-4 description, test description. Then I do add image. So it takes me to add image. Let me make it bigger. Okay. So now here I select an image. And then let's see if it has uploaded. We can check here. So I go to storage, I go to bucket. No, it has not updated yet. So let's wait for some time. Check here. No sign. Okay. Did you get any error? Let's see. Not an error itself. Okay. Okay, let's try it again and see. Cancel by second request. Okay, so that means the image was uploading and we just stopped it, right? So it says multiple requests. So we need to, because the image size is bigger, right? So it will take some time to upload. Got it. So let's see, usage settings, no problem. Let's go to usage. Okay, let's wait for a few minutes. So if you see here, my auth database, so the database has also not created any new things, right? So that means the image is still uploading. Okay, let me do one thing. Let me restart it and just select a smaller image. And let me do one thing here also. Let me delete this image. So I know this image is smaller. Maybe this is a bigger one. This is the smaller one and that is a bigger one. So let me just go again. Let's give a title of test 3 test and then select the image. Select the same image that I have done it for the last time. So let's wait now. It doesn't take this much time. Nope. Let me try again. Okay, you see, this is not getting called somehow. Let me see here. Oh wait, right? So in my case, what should happen is that it should first get the user ID. So create to do, right? Test 3 test 3, then I select this image. By default it should come to this part, but it's not running. So let me just restart the app. Maybe that should make it work. Let me restart it. So basically what happens is that once we get the image, we will upload the image, we get the file from the return function. From the function I get a file. Now I am returning the file. So when I return the file, I will get this file here, and then I will just place the file ID and the bucket ID, and then it will return true. So yeah, this is the thing that we are looking for. Let's wait for a few minutes and then we'll start. Okay, so now our app is running. Let's see if it is working now. Let me add a title, something. Select the image. What's the issue? Okay. I didn't click on add to do. Sorry, my bad. So let me remove everything from here. Let me click on add to do. Let me check if the image was uploaded. Yes, the image was uploaded. Go to the database. If you go to the database and go for this. So test 3, let's see, I got the image ID, I got the bucket ID, that's fine. Now, let me, I don't know what I have done here. So let me just reload it and check. So if I have done it correctly, I got test 3. Now, let's do one thing. Let's just show the image on the tab, right? So let me go to P, home screen. Here I say list style and then value, I say description, right? So I get the description here. So let me do one thing. Let me add string image ID, string bucket ID. Then I will just make it required. So require this dot bucket ID, require this dot image ID. Then I will do so I will do bucket ID equals to JSON bucket ID comma, then I will do image ID equals to JSON of image ID. Okay, let me restart now. Okay, so now I got the data. I will get the data. Okay, there is some error. Yes, we got the error. Null is not a type of string. Yeah, because we have null values, right? For this two, for the other items. So we'll make it a null. Okay, that's fine. So now what I will do is I will go to home screen and then I will put a onTap function. So let's say onTap, I will give onTap, and then I will do is I will get the file, right? To get the file, let's see what we can do is so let's go back to our documentation. If you don't know something, go back to the docs. Okay, let me open the documentation. Okay, this is documentation. I don't know why. So let me go to the document app, right? Oh, okay. No, not from here. So let's say appwrite.io, then go to docs, then go to storage, select Flutter, select Flutter. Now we have already have done the create. So list, I don't need list. Get file, right? So I need the get file. So what I need basically, I don't need this. I go to the docs for the guide, right? Yeah. Here, I will go down, create file, we have done it. Image manipulation, we don't need. Download and stream with range. Image manipulation. This is create. So what we need to do, we need to use storage, right? So let's do one thing like this. So let's say we will create a storage equals to storage from client. Yeah, and we'll get the client from main.dart. Now I will do storage dot, let's see, get file. So in the get file, I need the bucket ID. So I will say this thing. So I will say to do this and then dot bucket ID. So bucket ID, let's make it this. I will use this. Now I will copy this and paste it here and do dot image ID. Also use a exclamation mark to avoid null operation. So now let's see what it gives me. It gives a file. So I will also use file equals to, and then I will just import model. Okay, I can't do that here. So let me just also do that model and say as model or model. Okay. Now I will come here and I will do just write model dot file and then I will write await. Make it a async function. Okay, I don't need model, I guess. So if I remove it and also remove it from here, maybe this will work. Yeah, right. That is because I didn't make it a await function. Now I got the file. Now in the file, what I will have, let's see. In the file, we have ID, bucket ID, created app, permission, name, signature, mime type, size original, chunk total, chunk upload. Okay, but even if I got the file, how to show it, right? So it says get a file by its unique ID. This endpoint responds to a JSON object. Okay, then I should be able to show it. So let's see. Let's go to the storage for rest. Let's click on Flutter, maybe get file preview. Okay, get file. So I have already done it. So I will get the file by this. Get a file by the its endpoint returns a JSON object, the file metadata. But I need to show it. So I need a preview. So this is what we need to use. Get a preview of a preview. Get a file preview image. Okay. So here we already have storage. So we'll say future result this, right? Then bytes. Okay, let's do this. So I already have the write sync as byte. Okay, file. Now you see we can't use this. So basically, so I don't even need this. So I will remove model from here because I need to import io. So I will get the io dot dot io. Okay, now instead of this I will write to do provider dot to do's dot of index dot bucket id. Similarly, for the file ID, I'll just copy this, paste it here. Bucket, I will write image ID. Okay, now once I have written it into a path, right? So here I need to give a path. Okay, so let me do one thing. Instead of giving it a path, okay, I need to give it a path, right? So I need to get the document. So I need to add path here to my file. And then I can write. So if I go to the path, pub.dev and then I go for path package. Okay, so once I use this package, what I can do is I can get the temporary path. So let me just check the examples. No, not this one, not this path. Temporary path, maybe nothing like that. Let's search for it. Get the download path in Flutter. Oh yeah, right, I need to use path provider. So pub.dev, I forgot. So path underscore provider. So with the path provider, we can get the file system path. So I will copy this. I will paste it out here. Sorry, I will add it to the pub spec provider and then using this, and then I will get the temporary directory. So then I will add it out here. And then instead of path, I will write temp dir, and then I will add path to my import list. So let me go to the example. I need to import path provider, this thing. Okay, so now that we have the image, what we need to do is we need to go to this and then display the image, right? So we will display the image now. So future builder file ID, okay, so let's take this maybe. Okay, so I don't think now download is also required. Let me just remove this. Let me just show a show dialog, then I will create a alert dialog, then I can give a content, then I can give this future builder. So what does it say? It says, oh, okay, got it. So I just have to add a function here, right? So now I can use this. Okay, so it says snapshot.data. So I will just have to write as. So what does it need? It needs a unit 8. Let's try it. Copy that and paste it out here. Okay. Data. Let me see. What is the issue? It says object can't be assigned to a parameter type unit 8 list. Okay, so let me just create a unit 8 list data equals to unit 8 list dot from list, I don't need that, equals to snapshot dot data. Okay, Okay, this works. So now I will just again give the bucket ID here. So let's say todo provider dot todos dot of index dot bucket ID. Similarly, I give todo provider dot todos of index dot file or the image ID. Okay. So let's see now. We got something. Yeah, we got the image preview. So this is the way to show it on your, let's say if you want to have a preview, but if you want to download it, you have to use the other method, which is to this one, download the file. Okay. So yeah, so this was the video. I think I have covered all the processes of downloading, creating and uploading the file. So yeah, thank you for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one.